Hey, welcome to volume one of the How to Come Up series. So this How to Come Up series I'm gonna do is short snippets, outtakes of how you succeed, how you prosper, how you grow in a world that may not be all for you. It might be stacked against you. If you're a minority, if you're a woman, you're dealing with sexism and people who aren't necessarily comfortable with women in leadership roles. If you're a person of color, people, you might be dealing with racism, or you're disabled, you might be dealing with some kind of a bias or just straight up discrimination against the handicapped. If you're a senior citizen, maybe dealing with ageism, it's all kind of isms, all kind of issues, but you can still come up, right? I've been able to come up. And I grew up in Compton, California, in South Central LA. So how do you come up, right? That's what this series is going to be about. Tell all your friends about it. It's going to be a podcast. It's going to be a video series, a blog series. But the number one thing is I want you to learn about coming up. Number one thing, don't get emotional. I want you to be emotional about who you love. And I want you to be emotional about seeing flowers and looking at a painting, okay? The arts. I don't want you to be emotional about your life and decision making. Whatever decision you make that's emotional is going to be the wrong decision. And a lot of people who mean you no good or who want to stay in the position of success that they are in already, listen now, please, spread this message. They love you getting emotional. Because when you get emotional, you get hot and heated, okay? You start operating with this versus this. And I want you to not get emotional. I want you to get even. I don't want you to get angry. I want you to get even. You get even by winning, right? By succeeding. And I want you to learn that when you get emotional, you react, you don't respond. Write this down now. When you get emotional, you react, you don't respond. And life is 10% what life does to you, and 90% how you choose to respond to it. The question is, what's your response going to be? You cannot build wealth. You cannot stay on your game and focus on your own product development or sales or selling somebody your newest innovation or doing a great service. Even if you're running a business, don't take it personal, right? Business is business, not personal. And you start arguing with your client, your customer, you've already lost. You start arguing with a racist or somebody who means you no ill, who, by the way, is somebody you don't want to be like anyway, who probably doesn't matter. They're probably broke, okay? People who are angry, spend a lot of time dealing with anger, and who are mean-spirited people, typically are unsuccessful people too, because nobody likes hanging around all that drama. So to argue with a fool proves there are two. It's not what people call you. It's what you answer to that's important. And never, ever, ever answer out of your name. And to argue with a fool proves there are two. I don't want you to not get emotional because bias and racism, discrimination, and all that stuff somehow magically has disappeared. And by the way, you could be Caucasian and mainstream and still be discriminated against, or because somebody doesn't want you in their club, or maybe there's only one position and there's two people trying to get it, and you just, been pushed out because their buddy got the job. This could happen to anybody. But when you get emotional, you lose. You won the battle and lost the war. You won the battle, maybe, and you've lost the war. They write you off as being crazy. They say, see, I told you she was nuts, okay? And they write you out of the script. Call success. Getting emotional is the first lesson. Not getting emotional is the first lesson in training your brain, your mind, your spirit for success. I want you to be like a soldier. I want you to be like I want you to be a winner. I want you to learn to win. And it starts with staying focused and being intentional about what you think is important, not what somebody else thinks is important. And that's keeping the emotions out of your decision making. Pass this video on. Let me know what you think. Spread the word. I'm out.